Good, people of YouTube, my name is Spanner, welcome back for some more Dark Souls 2. So, last time we defeated the last giant, so let's head back to the Cardinal Tower bonfire over here. Let's unlock some more doors. We're using our brand new mace, upgraded to plus one. And let's see, last time I went to the door up those stairs, so now we'll go down here. We just kill this guy and the Halberd guy. No one likes you, Halberd guy. And the guy that's fake sleeping. Okay, door number two. Over here is a chest with some stuff. The Ring of Restoration. That ring will slowly regen your health. It's not really that great. Over here, there's a big open area with a Grand Lance. A Grand Lance is... well, it's a lance-type weapon, you can see over here. Weapon category Lance, with thrust and strike attack types. We can't use it yet, needs some more stats we don't have. And it has C-scaling on both strength and dexterity. And over here, we have the Amber Herb. Over this way, there's an enemy and a massive door. We can kill him. Let's go for a backstab. Okay, we need another backstab. And he's dead. And over here, we've seen the message, but I was in the middle of combat. Well, but it says, I'm sure you guys noticed it, produce the symbol of the king. Ah, there it is. Produce the symbol of the king. We don't have the symbol of the king. That's something for way, way down the line, near the end of the game. But that door exists, and it's over there, so let's not forget about it. Here is another door. And now here's the reason I lit this, this fire earlier. So we can go down here, because it's very dark. And we can light some more. Down here there are some skeletons, you can actually attack them before they finish reassembling. We got some black firebombs. Now black firebombs are like regular firebombs, but they deal more damage, I believe. And we also got the Alluring Skull. You can place it on the ground. Well, not place it, you can throw it, and it will lure certain types of enemies. Good if you need some sort of distraction. More skeletons. And we can light this sconce as well. And we got an extra torch. Now did I pick up all of the items over here? I probably did. Okay. So we are now going into an outside area. Be careful here, there are some archers. Well, there is one archer over there, but shouldn't be too much of a problem. Now, before we go up this ladder, we'll go over here and kill one. Two. And get another human effigy. Let's forget about this door for now. Let's go up here. And we have some of these armored guys. So good thing we have a mace, because strike weapons are great against these. Didn't roll in time, unfortunately. You do a wide swing, thank you. Human effigy. There's another one of those guys over there. And a whip. A whip is a dexterity type weapon. Like the one we got before, the old whip. But it has better scaling in dexterity. And no scaling in strength. And it requires less dexterity to use. But it deals less, way less base damage. 105 comparing to 233. And this old whip deals, has an attack boost against hollows. Hollows are, well, they're basically enemies like us, undead guys. Oh, and a bastard sword. That's not a bad weapon at all. What are the stats for this? Bastard swords. 20 strength, 11 dexterity. Bit more poise damage. And it's a slash thrust weapon. Alright, let's go through this door now. Trying to lure that guy over here. There's an enemy to the left. Archer as well. And over here, there's this item we saw way early on when we went, well, right after we left the Cardinal Tower bonfire, before we met with the boss that came from, that dropped down from the Raven, the giant Raven. Amber Herb and a Green Blossom. Now, when we go over here, the first thing you should do is light this bonfire. Because we're about to be invaded by an NPC, and I find this guy really annoying to deal with. He uses sorceries as well. I think a sword might be better against this guy. He's not heavily armored. So make sure you, anytime he starts casting something, make sure you try and dodge it. He'll also roll out of the way of your attacks, which can be hard to deal with. There he goes. Now, I wouldn't recommend doing this to NPC invaders, since they may actually drop some stuff. And over here is a giant. Doesn't have an item. Sometimes this guy will have, what's the thing called? Oh, a seed of a tree of giants, which is an item you could have chosen as your starting gift. Why is there a summon sign here? This is no place for a summon sign, unless someone needs help against armor, then it's over there, but... And we have the leather set with the hunter's hat. So anyway, what was I saying? Oh yeah, the seed from a tree of giants. It's an item. I can't remember exactly how it spawns. I think it has something to do with defeating invaders, but I'm not sure. I'll check it out for the next episodes. But yeah, that item, when you're invaded by a Dark Phantom, a red invader like old Dennis here, they cannot interact or be attacked by the monsters. Only you can attack them, and they can't do anything about the monsters too. If you use that item, the Seed of the Tree of Giants, that is no longer the case. So they can be attacked and attack as well, all the regular enemies in an area. Alright, let's get out of here. There's one more door left. And that door is over to this side. Now, the next boss is the same guy that dropped from the Raven. You could have killed him then, or you can kill him now. Killing him now is easier. I'm pretty sure it's the same guy. I remember killing that one once before killing him now, and he was no longer here. So yeah, it's the same guy, and it's a lot easier to kill him now, especially if you have some if you summon someone to help, because there are some ballistas in the boss area, and if you can hit the boss, if you can fire a ballista and it hits the boss, it deals like a ton of damage, like almost, I want to say almost half health. Oh, we got some common fruit. Common fruit temporarily boosts poison resist. There are many other items like this to boost other types of resistances. So back to talking about the boss. Yeah, if you have help, it's a lot easier, since someone can distract the boss and the other one will use the ballista. Now, bear in mind, the ballista bolts can actually hit your allies. So if you're the one, if you summon someone to help and you fire the ballista, you can hit your allies. If they're in the way, if they fire the ballista, they can kill you as well. So something to bear in mind. If you're alone, it's a lot harder to use the ballistas, because the boss will chase after you And he can actually destroy the ballistas with his attacks if he's close. But we're going to defeat him the good old-fashioned way. So he's heavily armored. So we're going to be using our mace, which is a strike weapon. And let's make ourselves a little bit lighter with the leather armor. Now there are, usually there are three different armor categories, which are light armor and a hat, why not? Gotta look fancy. Light armor, medium armor and heavy armor. Now these are usually, the categories are usually based on the weight. And I'm actually not sure, I know this was the case in Dark Souls 1. I think it's also the same here, but the heavier your armor, the you get less stamina regen, it regens a little bit slower. I'm actually not sure if it's based on the armor itself or the weight. Again, someone to check out for next episode. So let's heal up. And it's time to face the pursuer. Okay, he has a couple of attacks. This is one of them. You don't need to dodge this one. When he charges against you with the shields, all you gotta do is just move to the side of the shield, like this. Then he has a couple of swipe attacks. You can do one, two, or three. I usually prefer waiting until he does the thirds. Yeah, this time I started moving a little bit slower. You can also dodge, right? It's a bit safer, in case you don't move. You don't have the perfect timing. Okay, that attack, it's a grab attack. If he stabs you with the swords, you'll take a ton of damage. Okay, now that third swipe he just did, that's a bit tricky. It's better to dodge that, since the angle might fool you into just moving away. Because he does a slash, it kind of looks to me like he's going to do a slam, but he does a wide slash. Heal up, just in case I get hit some more. Come at me. Now he has that quiver-like thing on his back, but to my knowledge he only uses the swords. Okay, he also has an attack where he charges a smaller charge. That you've seen there. And he has another one that he hasn't used. I think he does a shield bash. And a triple stab behind the shield. Heal up. Now, one of the biggest pieces of advice I could give you against bosses is, if the boss is low, don't try to rush him down. Many, many times I've tried that and then I fell victim of that strategy. Okay, we got the Soul of the Pursuer and the Ring of Blades. Ring of Blades really useful for us, since it increases physical attack. So now we deal more damage with our weapons. Okay, now we can move on to this area. Here's another one of those giant trees. And now we can go, we're coming back here in a moment, but you can drop down this hole. And you can see that over there, which is the Dranglake armor set, minus the helmet. But this one, it has a lot of defenses, but it's a lot heavier. Now, since we have a heavy armor, finally, I can show you the roll at 88%. It's like this. Not a very good roll. If you're using heavy armor, you're usually not rolling. You'll probably block more often. But for now, I'll. We don't have a. Well, I do have a better shield now. We have Dranglake Shields, which it has 100% physical damage reduction, which is pretty good. And it has 55 stability, better than the other one we had, so it'll drain less stamina when we block something. I'm still using the boots. Back to leather. Oh, and we also got the Dranglake Swords. It's a great sword, we don't quite have the stats for it. And A scaling in dexterity, C in strength, not a bad weapon. So now we're going back up there, since we have some other business. Oh, you came all the way over here. Were you looking for me? Old ironclad armor. More heavy armor, we are now a turtle. You can see we move a little bit slower as well with heavier armor. So let's head back up here. You see this nest? We can examine it. And be taken by a giant raven, never to be seen again. Now we'll get transported to another area. The Lost Bastille. Now, this is a shortcut to this area. But we're not going to do much here. Oh, here's a dull ember. I'll explain what that is in a moment. Well, or maybe not a moment, maybe next time once we actually get to do something with it. Okay, first, let's not waste these souls. And go level up. But yeah, the Lost Bastille is, oh, it's actually the final, it's the final area of the first area. Maybe I'm being a bit, maybe what I said is a bit confusing, but, let's get some strength. Wait, what do I need for the bastard swords? Hold on, I'll go back to the thing I was saying in a moment. 2011. I think I can do that. Let's get a bit more strength. 28. Okay, let's use a bastard sword for now. Okay, so remember when I mentioned the four areas you need to go to defeat the four bosses with the large souls? Well, the Lost Bastille here is the final area of one of those paths. It's where one of the, well, technically it's not, but it's kind of, it's where one of the bosses is. One of the bosses resides. But we took a shortcut. We're technically not meant to be here yet. We'll be going the regular, we'll be taking the regular route eventually, but we can do something here first. Over here. Life gem and a titanite shards of the large variety. Over here is an enemy. And see this explosive barrel over here? You can push him if you jump and it will explode, killing a bunch of enemies down here, including these dogs. Okay, bastard sword has this heavy attack and a swiping attack, which is nice. And for two hands we have swipe and another swipe. Wasn't this a I thought it had a thrust attack. I guess that's the claymore. And over here there's a chest. Let's actually get my mace again. But if you go over here, surprise, it's the pursuer. Although he's a little bit different now, as he has a little bit of black smoke coming out of him. He has a new attack that you gotta be careful of if you're not ready. In this small area, be careful of that hole over there. You can fall and die. So let's just kill the pursuer. Oh, actually took a lot of damage there. Ow! That hurt a lot. We might need some agility to help with dodging. So let's do the same thing. Well, let's not fall down there. Alright, Mr. Pursuer. Round 2. There he is, come on. Another one of those. Bring it. Oh, another thing I don't think I mentioned, but whenever you're blocking, your stamina regeneration is a lot slower. And when you take a hit, and if you're blocking and you take a hit, and it drains your entire stamina, or the remaining stamina you have, you get staggered. Oh, here's the different attack. When he does this, run behind him. Otherwise, you're gonna take massive damage. And he dropped Twinkling Titanite. Okay, let's get our rewards. Here is the Covetous Silver Serpent Ring, the regular kind, which only boosts your the soul's gain by defeating enemies by 10% instead of the 20 we already got. And we also got a Fragrant Branch of Yore. So now I believe we have two. Oh no, we only have one? I thought I had another one. Oh yeah, I didn't buy the one from Malentia, that's right. Okay, anyways, I think we should stop here for now. So, thank you guys for watching, hope you enjoyed another episode of Dark Souls 2, and I'll see you all next time.